एवरीवन, आई एम मिसेस रुशाली चौधरी, लेक्चरर प्रवीण पाटिल पॉलिटेक्निक। वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अप्लाइड साइंस केमिस्ट्री, सब्जेक्ट कोड 2202 2211, वाटर ट्रीटमेंट एंड एनालिसिस। वी ऑलरेडी डन डिफरेंट प्यूरिफिकेशन प्रोसेस यूज फॉर द वाटर डिपेंडिंग अपॉन द इम्प्योरिटी। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न रिवर्स ऑस्मोसिस। It is a water purification process that is used partially permeable membrane to remove ions, unwanted molecules, larger particles from the drinking water. It is a process to remove the salt contained from the water. What is that? That is called also called as a desalination, demineralization, the process in which we are removing ions from the or the removing salts from the water. It's called as a desalination. It is a separation process used to reduce the dissolved salt contained from the saline water to convert it into the usable level. What is the saline water? Sea water, which is having a lot of sodium chloride dissolved salt, it's called as a saline water. From that we are going to remove out the dissolved salt which cannot be removed by the filtration process. That is called as a desalination, removal of salt. All desalination processes involve the three liquid streams: the saline feed water, that is a brackish water or sea water, low salinity produce water, and very saline concentrated brine or rejected water. The saline feed water is drawn or obtained from the oceans or the underground sources. It is separated by the desalination process into two output streams. We first understand the reverse osmosis concept. First, we will understand what is the osmosis. What is the osmosis? Here we take a U-shaped tube. In that, it is separated by using a semi-permeable membrane. And half portion is having a low solute concentration, half portion is having a high solute concentration. This is the red color particles. It's called as a high solute. Just like this is a sea water, samundar ka pani hai, which is having a lot of salt. This is your drinking water, very less amount of salt. If we keep these two solution in contact with each other, what will happen if the osmosis take place? This salt concentration will move towards the lower concentration and solution is become equivalent solute concentration. Both side the salt concentration become same after some time. They will mix with each other. Particles will travel from the high concentration towards the low concentration. And water is moving from the low concentration towards the high concentration. That is called as a osmosis. But what happened in the reverse process? We are reverse that process. We are not allowing water to move from low concentration to high concentration. In a reverse process, water is moving from the high concentration salt towards the low concentration salt, where we are applying the external pressure. This is a U-shaped tube which is having here the salt water, greenish color particles are there. This is the blue color, the fresh water. The fresh water is having very low salts, while sea water is having a lot of salts. So what will happen when we are applying the pressure? If it is a osmosis, what will happen? Fresh water will move towards the sea water. But this is the reverse osmosis. We are putting a pressure from the back side. Then what will happen? water will move from the high concentration towards the low concentration, and in this half portion we will get pure water which is suitable for drinking purpose. Here we are for the separating two solutions, we are using a semi-permeable membrane which is separated two solutions and allow water only to flow in purified direction. In this process we are using a membrane by which water is separated from saline water. Osmosis is defined as the spontaneous flow of water from the dilute to more concentrated solution through the semi-permeable membrane. But what happens in a reverse osmosis? The fresh water, that is a blue color, that is a moving towards the fresh water. Understand? In a osmosis, water is moving from the low concentration to the higher concentration. Even in the reverse osmosis, water is moving from the high concentrations towards the low concentration by using an external pressure. It is having a semi-permeable membrane which permits only water molecule to pass through it. Example of semi-permeable membranes are cellulose, acetate, polyamide and polyamides, different types of polyamide. Potassium ferrocyanide are used as a semi-permeable membrane for carrying out reverse osmosis. Where we are using this? This is the general diagram for the reverse osmosis. Here we are using the high pressure pumps for forces the water through pass through the semi-permeable membrane. This is the assembly tank used in an industry. This is the concept of water flow. It is used in an industry for manufacturing, drinking, power generation, water treatment, agricultural, wastewater treatment, food production, remote populations and a military purpose. Some MCQ we are going to solve. RO, reverse osmosis membrane, are made up of plastic, cotton, silk or polymer. Answer is polymer. RO means reverse osmosis, that is having a semi-permeable membrane. Oh, I have given a second question answer. Second question is, dash is used for the RO process. Highly permeable membrane, permeable membrane, semi-permeable or non-permeable. Answer is semi-permeable membrane used in a RO process, that is made up from polymers or the polyamides. Thank you so much for your attention. If you have any doubt, you can ask me during the online lectures. Thank you so much.